What's up, everybody? It's Man of Low Moral Fiber here. My name's Luke, and today we're going to be taking a look at the GodFinger as part of my Does It Suck series. The GodFinger is a Pearlescent Jakobs sniper rifle from the second Ultimate Vault Hunter upgrade pack, the one that adds to Destruct Peak. This weapon is most commonly found from tubby enemies. Now, the GodFinger has the special effect of dealing more damage when you're really far away from an enemy by having extra pellets that spawn a fair distance away, actually a pretty extreme distance away from where you fire it, and it'll be so far away that you'll never really get it if you're using velocity, so notice that I am definitely not specced into velocity at the moment. Now, this particular weapon has a really low base damage. If we compare it here to the Muckamuck, we can see that it is well under half of what the Muckamuck is. In addition to having an abysmal fire rate, this is one of the bolt-action Jacob sniper rifles where you actually have to do this little action every time you shoot it. And keep in mind, I am using a chaotic neutral rogue comm right now. If I didn't have that on, the fire rate would be a lot slower. So this is why I have to use the chaotic neutral rogue comm when using this gun. Otherwise, I wouldn't be able to have the requisite fire rate for proper critical ascension stacking. So we're going to go ahead and shoot this guy here and see how much damage it does. Get rid of the one-shot, one-kill bonus. So 1402K. That is bad. In comparison, with the Chaotic Neutral Rogue Comm and without the one-shot, one-kill bonus, the Muckamuck is going to do 3430. So the Godfinger is going to do a lot less than a standard Purple Jacobs, less than half. So that's something to keep in mind if that critical ascension stack will go away. When using the Godfinger, that if you're not at a super long distance away, it's going to suck. And you might be wondering how far that distance actually is. It looks like I'm pretty far from this test dummy right now, right? Still not far enough to get the extra bonus damage from this gun, so I don't know. It's really bad. We're going to use it in the Washburn Refinery and see how we do. I don't think there are too many maps where you can even get far enough away from the enemies to use the Godfinger properly. It's that bad. It's one of the worst sniper rifles I've ever had the displeasure of using. And I used it for certain things like killing the dragons once after I had already pre-stacked Critical Ascension. And it was just so irritating to use. It's truly one of the worst sniper rifles I've ever used. I mean, in addition to having an almost unusable special effect, it has an abysmal fire rate as well. So I guess we'll get Kunai and Slag on this guy and get as far away from him as we can. And then we'll try to kill him here. And he was already on low health there, and we didn't kill him in one shot with the one shot, one kill bonus. So we'll scoot back pretty far from this power loader and see if we're able to deal good damage to him. We're doing terrible damage to him at the moment, but we'll keep trying. We'll keep trying to use this gun and see if we can make it work at all for us. But as you can see, you know, even though I have critical ascension stacks right now, it's still doing bad damage. And now that this guy's fairly close to me, there's like no way I can kill him, so we'll try to shoot this guy back here. Just use this little guy to acquire a couple more rounds of critical or stacks of critical ascension, I guess. And as you can see, it's just doing literally almost nothing to these guys. That guy's a little bit further back. We'll try to hit him, but he's not slagged, so we'll try to hit this one up front again. All right, so we finally killed one of them. Excellent. So we finally have killed a few of these guys here. As you can see, though, I'm really far from this guy, and I'm still not dealing like a lot of damage to him by any means, so we'll scoot back even in here and see if that's enough to get this long-range bonus. I guess that was about as far as you need to be from an enemy for it to work. From here all the way back by that chest. So that's how far you need to be for this gun to actually give you its special effect bonus. Maybe if I scoot all the way up this ramp, I'll get it here on this guy. He's got too close to me, I think. Yeah, so, I mean, it's bad. It's really bad. It might be the worst. I think it might be the worst sniper rifle that there is. There's no real situation where you'll be far enough to actually use this weapon appropriately. So here we got a guy way far back there. We'll see if we're able to get him. Damn it, I missed with my one-shot, one-kill shot. And maybe this is one of those times where I actually should have used a Hyperion scope as opposed to a Dahl scope. But either way, this gun is bad, and it's not going to be good no matter what you really do with it. There's no real way to slow the bullets down and make the extra pellets come at a less extreme distance, so I don't know. It's so bad that, like, that's at 18 stack or 17 stacks of critical ascension. Just for comparison, that's what the muckamuck does at a similar stat count. So it's not, you know, it's not even really comparable, because that is just not comparable to what the Godfinger can do. I'll go up here and, you know, try to hit this badass loader with the Godfinger from all the way down the hallway, and we'll see if that is enough to, you know, get the distance we need from that enemy. So I'm just gonna rush down here. I'll try to get an execute that'll send. Ah, come on, game. So, eh. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and knock the arm off this guy here. All right, so just get a few stacks of critical ascension, I guess, off this guy. Alright, so now we're at, like, above 50 stacks of critical ascension, right? We'll go ahead and we'll kill this guy. Get slag on him, I guess. And then we'll turn around and we'll shoot the Godfinger, and we'll see if it's going to be enough to kill this guy. I'll have to get a good shot on him, I guess. We'll see if I'm actually able to hit that critical. So even at this distance, with 50 stacks of critical ascension on a slagged enemy, it was not enough to one-hit that badass loader. I'll get a couple more rounds of ammunition here, and we'll go back and we'll try to hit him again. But, I mean, if that doesn't show you how bad this weapon is, I don't think there's really anything that will. What's really surprising to me is that there's a number of people out there who think that this weapon is half-decent or good, even, and I don't know why. Obviously, it can be abused with the B, those extra pellets that come out after a long distance do get the extra B boost, but, I mean, why would you even need that? You could just use the Pimpernel at long range, you know what I mean? And it would be a better option. And, I don't know, it's like, if I want to fight enemies, I usually engage them at, like, a reasonable distance as opposed to this nonsense that you have to do with the Godfinger. So, I don't know. I wouldn't really recommend the Godfinger in any situation. It's so bad that I just can't say that it doesn't suck. Maybe I'm just bad at it, you know, but I've never seen anyone use it well. I've never seen it used properly. I've never seen it used to good effect. It's just, I mean, if this isn't the distance that it's good at, I don't think there is a distance it's good at. You know what I mean? It's that bad. Ugh, God, this gun sucks. Like, it sucks bad, too. Not just a little bit. I don't know. It's just, it's not worth using. That's for sure. Some people might like it for some unknown reason to me, but I can't see a reason why anyone would ever want or need to use this weapon. Now that I've switched to the muckamuck, you'll notice that I'll actually do damage to these guys. And, you know, in addition to having an almost unusable special effect, the Godfinger, it has obviously an almost unusable fire rate, so I have to be using this chaotic neutral rogue comm with it as well if I want to fire at a reasonable speed, and that's not very good either. I mean, we'll try it here with the one-shot, one-kill bonus. No, not with the one-shot, one-kill bonus, but now with the one-shot, one-kill bonus on a slagged enemy from a distance, it's still not, it's bad. I mean, I'll go ahead and get slag on this guy here. Excellent. Slag and kunai and one shot, one kill bonus, and no. It's useless. Don't ever use the Godfinger. It's that bad. Got this guy pretty far distance away. We'll see if we can get him. Oh my god, this gun blows. No, there's no reason to ever use the Godfinger. It's so bad that it's nigh unusable. It might be the worst Jakobs sniper. It might be the worst sniper rifle in the game, in my opinion. It's that bad. There's nothing redeeming about this gun at all. I do not like it. I have not been a fan of using it. It's been so bad that it put me in a bad mood. It's that bad. This gun is terrible. The answer to does it suck regarding the Godfinger is a resounding yes. If anybody has any footage of the Godfinger not sucking, go ahead and point me in the right direction, because the Godfinger is garbage. That's a gun that doesn't ever need to see the light of day. It's a bad gun, and I wouldn't recommend using it for anything ever. It's that bad. So, as always, guys, I thank you very much for watching. I do appreciate it. If you haven't yet taken the time to subscribe, please do so. I'd really appreciate that as well. Otherwise, I do hope to catch you next time. Bye, guys.